What's up, everyone? I'm Helena Olamu, and welcome to another episode of the DNA Download, where we explain the science of genetics so you can live in the know. Sometimes I hear on the news, scientists have discovered the gene for something. The gene for being shy, the gene for getting gray hair, the cuddle gene, the warrior gene. Now, I'm all for making new genetic discoveries, but is there really a specific gene for every trait? That's the question I'm hoping to get answered, and here to help is Dr. Sarah Lasky, a scientist on the health R&D team at 23andMe. Thanks for being here, Sarah.
Thank you for having me, Helena. And you know, the truth is, there is no one single magic gene for most things.
Okay.
In reality, for most traits and medical conditions you can think of, there are gonna be hundreds or even thousands of DNA variants that can affect it.
So you're saying it takes a village?
Absolutely. And we can use an example. So let's talk about your wake up time, Helena.
Okay.
Would you say that you're more of a morning person or a night owl?
I'm definitely not a morning person. But wait, are you saying DNA may affect what time I like to get up in the morning?
Absolutely. And wake up time is a perfect example of a trait that's affected by hundreds of different genes. Scientists call this a polygenic trait.
Oh, okay, I think I get it. Poly means many and genic means genes. So polygenic trait, a trait that's affected by many genes?
Absolutely.
So can 23andMe tell me what time I like to wake up in the morning just based on my DNA?
Well, not quite. 23andMe can tell you about the genetic component, but what time you wake up in the morning is gonna depend on a bunch of other things. What time you went to sleep, how comfortable your bed is. Another big one is age. So the older people get, the earlier they like to wake up in the morning.
Okay, so my wake up time is affected by my genetics, my lifestyle, and my environment. Well, that is one complicated trait.
Yeah, scientists literally call traits like this complex traits.
So are all traits this complex, or is wake up time especially complicated?
Actually, most traits in medical conditions are complex like this. The one big exception is these very specific genetic diseases. Most of them are super rare and most people have never heard of them, but some of the more common examples you may have heard of are sickle cell anemia and cystic fibrosis.
Got it. So next time I hear someone refer to the gene for something, I'll know that there's probably a lot more to the story.
Oh yeah, you know, that one gene could be important, but chances are it is one small piece of a much bigger puzzle.
Huh. Well, I'm definitely less puzzled than I was when we started the interview. Well, thanks again so much for being here, Sarah. And see you next time on the DNA Download.